was the night before baseball when all through the land, all the creatures were stirring after lockdowns and bans. The masks were all hung in the lockers with care, in hopes that the players soon would be there. The Hoosiers were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of Omaha danced in their heads. And Dr. Fauci and crew were reviewing the stats to determine how long until all got a vax. When in Mellencamp there arose such a clatter of practice swings taken by many a batter, winter weather in B-Town made all the teeth gnash, so the team ran inside for some baseballs to bash. 2020 was shortened, as baseball fans know, so the Hoosiers were ready to put on a show. As the start of the season began to creep near, the details of schedule were anything but clear. If Big Ten fans were hoping for schedule news quick, the slow-moving conference made many skeptics. But regardless of who should shoulder the blame, the team couldn't wait to hear coach call their names. Now Houston, now Summer, now Bierman and Ashley, on Grants, on Barr, on Manis and Fusey. Now gather round, team, we've put time in this fall. It's been quite a year, but it's time to play ball. 2020 was done in the blink of an eye, and now expectations had soared very high. Much work was put in by the Hoosiers and crew, although this next year would look really quite new. The non-conference games were now gone in a poof, and Big Ten restrictions left no room to goof. With just 44 games to be postseason bound, the Hoosiers will need to beat all their foes down. With the team stuck inside due to snow underfoot, the staff used their data to track all the output. The analytics they knew could help pick up the slack and make sure that IU was the top of the pack. As the reigning big champs, the team was quite scary, and they knew their opponents would be pretty wary. They would be a top target for many a foe, and as a top team, they could not lie low. So as the team waited for warm weather relief, into an Omaha ending, they put their belief. They had almost a year for this day to make ready, and so in the meantime, they made their growth steady. The team was preparing to give it their best to be the top team throughout the Midwest. They continued to work to push further ahead, which gave us to know we had nothing to dread. Coach spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and thought of the season with his own little smirk. His team would be ready to put on some shows, to battle opponents, and make some great throws. He went to his office, to his team gave a whistle, and to Minnesota they flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy season to all, and to all a good night."